Hey, this is Bobby from LickNRiff.com, and it's time for another viewer request. And in this video, we're going to learn a fingerstyle arrangement I've made especially for you guys and girls of La Isla Bonita. You may be surprised, but yeah, it makes a really good fingerstyle arrangement. And first, I'm going to play it for you. Then we're going to break it down lick by lick with tabs on the screen as usual. First, it goes like this. Okay, so this is pretty short, pretty easy, pretty sweet. It's got a very short intro, a verse, and then a chorus with two different endings. Then it's got a bridge. The bridge is the longest part, surprisingly. That doesn't happen very often. Usually the bridge is very short, but in this, the verse is very short, the chorus is very short, and then the bridge is suddenly a composition within itself. So, the intro is just A minor and G. Now, it's all about the rhythm here. A minor goes on for three beats, and then on the fourth beat, you play G. So it's... Okay, it's all about the rhythm. Now, even if I write the tabs accurately, you still have to hear the rhythm in your head, because tablature has no rhythm in it. That's its huge disadvantage. It's one disadvantage. So it's just da 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 G, da 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 G. Pretty simple. Just apply it to the chord. Play the chord in any way you want. Okay? Or just play the bass note once and let it ring. You can also arpeggiate the chord just a little. Okay, just create your own little rhythm there. It's just a rhythm, just chords. You can practically play whatever you want as long as you keep the feel going. The feel of da-da-ba-ba-ba-ba. Okay? Yeah. Ba. Jazz hands. I went there. All right. So the verse goes like this. A minor. You just play the bass along with the G string, then the D string, then the G string again. Okay? Third string, fourth string, third string. Then G, you can just put your first finger on the bass, on three on the E bass, and play that bass along with the second string, then third string, then second string. Okay? B string, G string, B string. Open. So, A minor, G, then A minor again, and the melody is this. One pull off to zero on the B string, one again. You can harmonize it in any way you want. You can play the chord along with it. You can play just the G string along with it. You can play the chord once. Or at the beginning. Okay? or you can find more creative ways to do it, okay, as long as you play the bass along with the first note. Then, F. Now, there's a reason I play it like this instead of this, because we want the E string open. And we have to hammer on 3 on the B string. So I put 1, 2, and 3 with fingers 1, 2, and 3 on the 2nd, 3rd, and 4th strings and have the E string open. So it's an F major 7. Now it's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And I put the thumb on the F bass on 1 on the E bass string. So I play the bass, then I play the chord twice, strings 2, 3, and 4. Then you can either play the chord again or just the B string and hammer on with your pinky from 1 to 3 on the B string. And then the open E string. Okay, so bass, chord, chord, hammer on, E string. Then C. Just a normal C chord. You play the chord, strings 1, 2, 3, and 5. Then the B string twice, then the E string again. Okay, all inside the chord. The B string on 1. You don't take anything off. Okay, pretty simple. Chord, second string twice, first string. Then 3 on the B string with the G bass. You can harmonize with the G string, with both the G and D strings, okay, to give a fuller chord sound. And the melody is 3-0-0 on the B string. And that's the verse. I told you it was short. It's, except for the F chord, it's all really, really simple chords, A minor, G, and C. So, again, A minor. G, A minor, F, okay, bass, chord, chord, hammer on, open E string, C, G, 3-0-0 on the B string, and you play that twice. So that's the verse. Now for the chorus. The chorus goes like this. It's A minor and E minor. Both of them played basically the same way. Strings 2, 3, and 4. Again, you can leave the 4th string out of it and just play the 1st and 2nd strings as your melody and harmony. So, A bass, play strings 2 and 3. Okay, 4 times. Then E minor, play the bass and strings 2 and 3 twice, and you have the line. Okay, bass, chord, 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 bass, chord, chord. I know it sounded funny, but that's what it is. And then it's this. Same idea, this time with D minor and C. Exactly the same idea. Okay, you don't play the E string at all. You play the D bass, then strings 2 and 3, then quickly move to C, play the C bass, play strings 2 and 3. Exactly the same rhythm. Then it's this. Again, you can just put a finger on the bass on 3 and play. The melody is open B string. Then 1 on the B string, you can harmonize it any way you want. You can play the chord once, you can play the chord all around. Okay? I think that's a little too much. You want to give the ear a rest between chords. And then it's this. Why? Because it's D minor. And if I'd have used this this shape, it would be really, really lean. It doesn't have any substance to it, so I used this. This is kind of the classical D minor. Okay, it's 5 on A, 3 on D, and 1 on G. Now, you play the A bass on 5, the A string on 5. This is D. Okay, and with the open B string, then you play strings 3 and 4 on 2 and 3. Okay, so now this sounds really weird when you play it out of context, but it works. Now you can play the B string first, then the bass, then the chord, and then you have time to move the chord around. Then you have time to make the transition smoothly. Okay, so let's do it that way. Open B string, 5 on A, rest of the D minor chord. Now for the endings. Two different endings. First ending is this. It's A minor. You play strings 3, 4, and 5. Okay, or play the bass once and then the third and fourth strings twice more. Then E minor, just once, play strings 2, 3, 4, and 6. Then A minor again, and pull off from 1 to 0 on the B string, then play 1 on the B string again. Okay, again, you can play the chord as a harmony to any of the notes you wish, or just the first notes. Okay, A minor, 3 times, E minor once, A minor, 1 pull off to 0, 1 right back on the B string. Now let's learn the second ending, and then we'll play the entire chorus again. So, the second ending is this. You play the G string again, okay, on this chord, on the D minor chord, the A note, and then you play this, okay? This is an A7 sus 4 shape, but you play it with the E bass, so it's E minor 7. And there's a reason you put the pinky on, because you need the first finger on the second string. The melody is 3-1. And I could have played this in open strings, but the lower seventh sounds really, really somber, and it kind of dirties up the chord, so I prefer to play another E note there and have the high seventh. So it's 2 on the fourth string with your second finger and a pinky on 3 and on 3 on the second string. So you have strings 2, 3, and 4 on 3, 0, and 2 with the E bass. And you play that. Then you play that without the pinky and 1 on the B string instead. Okay? And then strings 3 and 4 open. Then open again and you hammer on 2 and 2. And then you play the A bass. And then you're back to the intro. So it's... Okay? And you can skip the first beat. Just to accentuate the line. So the chorus. A minor, E minor. D minor, C. Same rhythm. G with 1 on the B string at the end. classical D minor, A minor, E minor once, A minor again, then again, G string, E minor, 7, lick, hammer on to A5 because we're not playing the minor note during that lick. So last the second ending, okay, now it makes sense. Great. Now for the unusually long bridge, the C part. It starts like this. D minor, then open E string, 3 on the B string, okay, it's still inside the chord. Then you change it really quick to B flat, major. Now, there's no reason to put the second finger on, so you can just put the bar on 1 and the pinky and third fingers on 3 and 3 on the B and G strings. And that's what you play. You play strings 2, 3, and 5. Then you lift the bar off of the E string and you play 0 and 1 on the E string. I said B string, sorry. You lift the bar off of the E string. Actually, off of all of the strings, you just leave the bass note going so it can keep ringing. And you play 0, 1 on the E string. Then C, just your normal run-of-the-mill C chord. Then 3, 1 on the B string. Then G, 3 on the B string, 3 on the E bass. Don't play the E string. Okay? You can play strings 2, 3, 4, and 6. So that was the first phrase. D minor, B flat, C, G. Then you're still on this G. You play the second string and the first string on 3 and 0. Then D minor again. Then the same thing. Open E string, 3 on the B string. Then it's this. It's D. It's B flat 6 for a second, because this time you do put all three fingers on, but you don't put them on these strings. You put them on these strings. I don't know if you could notice the change, but you put them on strings 1, 2, and 3. Okay, on 3, 3, and 3. On the first strings. Not strings 2, 3, and 4 like a normal B flat chord. You put them here because you want the 6th sound. And you play that, strings 1, 2, 3, and 5. Then you take the pinky off. Then you play the B string. Then you take the pinky off and play 1 on the E string. Okay, so it's... Got it? B flat 6, second string on 3, to pinky off, first string on 1, it's the bar. So it's... Then it's C. C, E string again, 1 on the E string, C again. That's it. Then it's D minor, B flat, C and G again, only this time you employ the B flat 6 again. So it's... And then you play the C and G just like you play them on the first phrase. So you actually combine it. You play the D minor, B flat 6 off of the second phrase and then C and G off of the first phrase. So it's D minor... Okay, just like you played it a couple of times before. Then B flat 6, exactly like you played it before. Okay, exactly the same lick. Then C and G, exactly the same time, exactly as you played them the first time. Okay, C3-1 on the B string, G. So B flat 6. Okay, B string 1 on the E string, then C, then G. Then the second string and first strings again on G. I say again because that's what we played the second time. This is the second time. I may be rushing a little. Sorry, don't know why. I'm gonna try and slow it down, even though it's kind of the end of the lesson already. Then D minor. Same lick again. Okay, it's the same lick on D minor throughout the bridge. Then it's then it's the same B flat to C lick as the first phrase. If this is confusing you, just follow the tab. It's repetitive. You play the first phrase, you play the second phrase, then everything repeats itself. Okay, only in a different order. So you play D minor, and then B flat again, strings 2, 3, and 5. Then the bar off and back on. Okay, 0, 1 on the E string, then C. Okay, and then it's a bar of C. And then it's E, and you play strings 3, 4, and 6. Then the G string again, then A minor. And you play strings 3, 4, and 5. The A5 again, and you're back to the intro. So it's D minor, B flat, 0, 1 on the E string, C. Then you pass the bar any way you want. You play the chord in any way that feels natural to you. Just continue the rhythm. E, A minor. Okay? Loves a girl. So then you're back to the intro. So the C part, the bridge, again, now it'll make sense when we connect the dots and make it into a complete C part, is this. D minor, B flat, C, G, D minor, B flat 6, C, D minor, B flat 6, C, G, D minor, B flat, C, E, A minor. Okay, it's and then you're back to the intro. So before you go practice this, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. There's a ton of lessons here waiting for you. If you're not subscribed, please do. And go to the website, download the tab. It's for free. Everything is for free. The link is in the description. But if you want to give something back to LickNRiff to contribute to the production of these lessons and the arrangement, you can donate. There's a donation button on the website. You can't miss it. It's a large blue button right above the tab file. And I'd be grateful for any donation whatsoever. Everything goes right back into LickNRiff, into making these arrangements, making the lessons, shooting them, editing them, uploading them. It all takes time and work. It's a lot of fun, but it's an effort. So if you wish to contribute, then thank you. I thank you in advance for it. You go practice this now. Go get this under your fingers. It's a lot of fun to play. It's a really great rhythm, and it's something nice to know, you know. Nobody expects you to play this as a fingerstyle arrangement, and I like this sort of stuff. So I'll see you the next lesson. You have fun with this, and thank you very much for watching.